جزى الله بالخيرات عنا أئمة لنا نقلوا القرآن عذبا وسلسالا فمنهم بدور سابعة قد تواسطت سماء العلا والعدل زهرا وكمالا.
Inshallah ta'ala, in this episode, I want to answer a very important question as well, like we answered in our previous episode. And the question that I want to answer in this episode is, هل قرأ النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بهذه القراءات? Did the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم recite the Qur'an with these قراءات that we have today? وَالَّذِي يَظْهَرُ وَالْعِلْمُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. That which seems apparent and clear from the Qur'an itself and from the Sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and from the statements of the Sahabas and the great Imams is that the Qur'an and the qira'at that we have, the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام recited it. Anyone who claims otherwise and says that's not the case, فَهُوَ مُطَالَبٌ لِبِالدَّلِيلِ. We request that person to bring evidence to us. Provide us with evidence. Why do you think this? What is your evidence in this situation? I'm going to provide some evidences to show that the Prophet ﷺ read the Quran with these qira'at. Even that though we have discussed it in our previous episodes, we have debunked that. But again, some people, they like to hear things in a more clear, and not only that, they also like to hear it structured in a particular way. So I hope that inshallah ta'ala I have done in this episode for them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in the Quran, وَإِنَّكَ لَتُلَقَّ الْقُرْآنَ مِنْ لَدُنْ حَكِيمٍ عَلِيمٍ. Allah tells the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that he has taken the Quran from the wise, knowledgeable one, and Allah azza wa jalla. وَإِنَّكَ لَتُلَقَّ الْقُرْآنَ. You receive this Qur'an from Allah Azza wa Jalla. The Qur'an is taken from Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it's through Jibreel, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam received it. Allah then subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded the Prophet to convey this Qur'an. Allah says, يَا أَيُّهَا الرَّسُولُ بَلِّغْ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ. Muhammad, convey that which has been sent to you from your Lord. بَلِّغْ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ. Convey that which has come to you from your Lord. So the Qur'an came from Allah Azza wa Jalla. The qira'at came from Allah Azza wa Jalla. And we've already explained in our previous episode that the qira'at al-ashara al-mutawatira are the Qur'an. Umar ibn al-Khattab and Zayd radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, may Allah be pleased with both of them, they said, الْقِرَاءَةُ سُنَّةٌ يَأْخُذُهَا الْآخِرُ عَنِ الْأَوَّلِ فَقْرَأُوا كَمَا عُلِّمْتُمُوهُ. That the qira'ah of the Qur'an, the qira'at, are a sunnah taken by the one who comes after from the one who came before him, and is passed on. فَقْرَأُوا, read, they said, كَمَا, the way عُلِّمْتُمُوهُ, you were taught. And the Qur'an is taught. Also Ali ibn Abi Talib, he said, إن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يأمركم أن تقرأوا القرآن كما علمتم. That Ali ibn Abi Talib, he said that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he commanded us to recite the Quran, or he commanded you all to recite the Quran the way you were taught. The evidence to show that the Sahabas رضوان الله عليهم أجمعين, that they used to take the Quran from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and they wouldn't just go out and read themselves, and whichever recitation they liked or whatever they felt was nice or felt good, that they didn't just recite it like that. The evidence for that is the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he came to Abdullah ibn Mas'ud and he said to him, اقرأ علي القرآن. Abdullah, read the Quran on me. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud was taken back. He said, مستغرباً, shocked and taken back. أَقْرَأُ عَلَيْكَ وَعَلَيْكَ أُنزِلْ. Shall I read the Qur'an on you when the Qur'an came down on you? What Abdullah ibn Mas'ud is taken back by is that he hears the Qur'an from the Prophet ﷺ. He studies the Qur'an from the Prophet ﷺ. The Prophet is his teacher. Now the Prophet is asking him to read onto him, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So Abdullah ibn Mas'ud is taken back by this. He's like, you want me to read the Qur'an on you? And it came down on you, showing you that the Sahabas never used to read the Qur'an on the Prophet, but the Prophet used to read on them. And they took it from his mouth, alayhi salatu wasalam, and that it was transmission. Also, the other evidence that shows that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam was the one who taught the Sahabas the Qur'an, and they took it from him, and they memorized it from him, is the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ وَعَلَّمَهُ. The best amongst you is the one who learns the Qur'an and then teaches the Qur'an. And you learn the Qur'an first and then you pass it on. And that's what the Sahabas رِضْوَانُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِمْ did. They took it from the Prophet's mouth and they passed it on. The qira'at was taken from the Prophet and the Sahabas passed it on like that. No Sahabi came and put something in there, inserted a verse in there. Not at all. La Uthman or other than Uthman. Al-Imam Abu Ubaid Qasim al-Sallam, he narrated in his kitab al-Masahif. Also, Abu Bakr ibn Mujahid in his kitab al-Sab'a, that Asim ibn Bahdala, يعني Asim ibn Bahdala, his name is Bahdala, some scholars they said. But he's known as Asim ibn Abi Nujud. Asim is the one whose recitation we recite the Qur'an on. Asim has two students, and he's from the 10 qira'at, from the 10 reciters. Rather, he's from the 7 al-Imam al-Shatibi mentions in his Hirz al-Amani wa Wajh al-Tahani. Asim has two students. He has Hafs and Shu'bah. Shu'bah and Hafs are the two students of Asim. Asim took the Qur'an from Ali ibn Abi Talib through Abi Abdulrahman al-Sulami, Abdullah ibn Habib. And Asim also took the Qur'an from Abdullah ibn Mas'ud through Zir ibn Hubaysh. He narrated the Qur'an to Hafs through Abi Abdulrahman al-Sulami to Ali ibn Abi Talib. And he narrated he taught the Qur'an to Shu'bah through Zir ibn Hubaysh to Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. That's why the two students of Asim, they read slightly different because it's taken from two companions. Shu'bah's recitation is Abdullah ibn Mas'ud and Hafs is the recitation of Ali ibn Abi Talib. Through Ali, he was Abu Abdurrahman al-Sulami, Abdullah ibn Habib, and through Shu'bah, it's Zir ibn Hubaysh. ولذلك, Asim, he's chained between the Prophet is two. He's got Tabi'i and a Sahabi. Lakin higher than him is Ibn Kathir and Ibn Amir. Ibn Kathir and Ibn Amir are higher than Asim. That's a side benefit, inshallah ta'ala, for the students. But Asim ibn Abi Najud, he narrated, or he mentioned, as it's in the book Kitab al-Sab'ah, or Abu Ubaid mentions in Kitab al-Masahif, that the story when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to Ubay, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Ubay, "Inna Allah amarani an aqra alayk." Allah commanded me to recite on you. Or another wording, which is umirtu an aqra alayk. I was commanded to read on you. And then Ubay was taken back. He said, "Ya Rasulullah, did Allah mention me by name and tell you to recite on me?" And the Prophet said, "Yes." And then Ubay read on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Here, Asim, he said, "I asked the son of Ubay. I asked him, I said to him," his name was Tufail ibn Ubay ibn Ka'bin. "I asked him, I said to him, what did your father understand from the statement of the Prophet, umirtu an aqra alayk? What did your father understand from it?" He said, "My father understood from this that the Prophet was saying that to him because liyaqra alayya fa'akhudha alfadahu." He understood from it that the Prophet wanted him to read, the Prophet wanted Ubay to read on him so he can take the wordings, the pronunciation, and everything from the Prophet ﷺ. Yani, the Prophet wanted to correct him. Don't recite like this, recite like this. And this proves our point, which is the qira'at is taken from the Prophet ﷺ. And the Prophet recited it ﷺ. Another strong argument is Umar ibn al-Khattab and Hisham ibn Hakim, when they both argued amongst themselves on their recitation, both of them didn't say, oh, this is how I read the Qur'an, this is how I liked reading the Qur'an. Both of them said, أَقْرَأَنِيهَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ, the messenger recited it like this for me. And both of their recitation was different. And when they both came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the Prophet said to both of them, هَكَذَا أُنزِلَتْ, هَكَذَا أُنزِلَتْ. To Umar, the Prophet said, yes, like that it came down. And to Hisham, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said to him, like that it came down. Showing you both of them attributed their recitation to the Prophet. None of them said, I read the Qur'an, I read it from a mushaf, and that's how I felt was the best way to read it. No. Also, another strong evidence to show you that the Prophet recited the Qur'an with the qira'at is, if we say that the Prophet didn't recite the Qur'an with the qira'at, or the Prophet didn't recite these qira'at, then we are basically slandering al-i'jaz al-bayani lil-Qur'an al-Kareem. The Qur'an has miracles, okay? Many four ways that the Qur'an is a mu'jiza. One of the four is al-i'jaz al-bayani lil-Qur'an al-Kareem. The Qur'an is a miracle in its wording. And it can only be a miracle in its wording if it all came from Allah Azza wa Jalla. If parts of it came from a human, it lacks this quality, or it lacks this distinct thing that the Qur'an has, which is it being a miracle from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now I'm going to give you four quotes of four great imams who've all stated that the qira'at are taken from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The first scholar is Abu Amr al-Dani rahimahullah. Abu Amr al-Dani, he said, وهذه القراءات كلها والأوجه بأسرها من اللغات هي التي أنزلت القرآن عليها وقرأ بها رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وأقرأ بها وأباح الله تعالى لنبيه القراءة بجميعها وصوب الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم من قرأ ببعضها دون بعض. Abu Amr al-Dani rahimahullah, he said, وَهَذِي الْقِرَاءَاتِ, these qira'at that we see, the 10 qira'at, al-ashara, all of them, with their awjuh, their forms, all of them, with their ways, هِيَ الَّتِي أُنزِلَتْ الْقُرْآنَ عَلَيْهَا, the Qur'an was said like this. وَقَرَأَ بِهَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ, the Prophet recited it like this. وَأَقْرَأَ بِهَا, and it was recited from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam like this. And like this, it was recited to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. وَأَبَاحَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى لِنَبِيِّ الْقِرَاءَةِ, and Allah تبارك وتعالى permitted the Prophet ﷺ to recite the Quran in these forms, in these qira'at. بِجَمِيعِهَا وَصَوَّبَ الرَّسُولُ, and the Prophet even said, the one who recites with these qira'at, you're right, like he did for Hisham ibn Hakim and Umar ibn al-Khattab. مَنْ قَرَأَ بِبَعْضِهَا دُونَ بَعْضٍ. So all of these qira'at are from the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. None of them are from these imams. None of them are from these imams. ولذلك إبراهيم النخعي رحمه الله, he used to hate the concept of saying قراءة فلان وقراءة فلان وقراءة فلان. He didn't like that. He disliked that. He wanted the قراءات not to be attributed to people, because people, they might think that this imam came with the قراءة. He didn't. It came from who? It came from the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. Likewise, the second great imam, al-imam al-Baghawi rahimahullah, he said, إِذْ لَيْسَ مَعْنَى هَذِي الْحُرُوفِ أَنْ يَقْرَأَ كُلُّ فَرِيقٍ بِمَا شَاءَ مِمَّا يُوَافِقُ لُغَتَهُ مِنْ غَيْرِ تَوْقِيفٍ بَلْ كُلُّ هَذِي الْحُرُوفِ مَنْصُوصَةٌ وَكُلُّهَا كَلَامُ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ نَزَلَ بِهَا الرُّوحُ الْأَمِينُ على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يدل عليه قوله إن هذا القرآن أنزل على سبعة أحرف. Al-imam al-Baghawi rahimahullah, he said, these different types of ahruf, It's not for anyone to recite as he wishes. Oh, I speak this language in the Arabic language, so I can recite whatever way I want to. لا. من غير توقيف, without having a textual evidence for it. بل كل هذه الحروف, rather all of these different recitations, منصوصة, they all have textual evidence for it. وكلها كلام الله عز وجل, and all of them are the words of Allah. Jibreel came down with it to our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the evidence for that is إن هذا القرآن, this Qur'an, أنزل على سبعة أحرف, that this Qur'an has been sent down in these seven أحرف. Sent down. All of it has been sent down like this. Now I'm going to mention the third Imam, Al-Imam Ibn Hajar rahimahullah. He said, إِنَّ الْإِبَاحَةَ الْمَذْكُورَةَ لَمْ تَقَعْ بِالتَّشَهِي أي إِنَّ كُلَّ أَحَدٍ يُغَيِّرُ الْكَلِمَةَ بِمُرَادِفِهَا فِي لُغَتِهِ بل المراعى في ذلك السماع من النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ويشير إلى ذلك قول كل من عمر وهشام في حديث الباب أقرأني النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Ibn Hajar رحمه الله, he said, the permissibility that's been mentioned for everyone to read in these different qira'at, it's not from the angle of a tashahi, يعني whichever one you like, whichever way you want to read the Qur'an you can. No. إِنَّ كُلَّ أَحَدٍ يُغَيِّرُ الْكَلِمَةَ بِمُرَادِفِهَا فِي لُغَتِهِ. That everyone can look at a word and say, oh, a synonym in my language is this, so I can read it like this. بَلِ الْمُرَاعَ فِي ذَلِكَ السَّمَعَ. This all goes back to what was transmitted from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the evidence for that, he said, is the evidence that we gave before, which is Umar and Hisham. Both of them, when they argued, they attributed it to the Prophet by saying, أقرأني النبي. The Prophet recited it to me like this. The last and final Imam that I want to mention is Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah. He said, وَإِنَّمَا الْمَقْصُودُ التَّنْبِيهَ عَلَى ذَلِكَ كُلُّهُ مِمَّا بَلَغَهُ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَمَ إِلَى النَّاسِ وَتَلَقَّاهُ أَصْحَابُهُ عَنْهُ الإيمان والقرآن حروفه ومعانيه وذلك مما أوحاه الله إليه كما قال تعالى وكذلك أوحينا إليك روحا من أمرنا ما كنت تدري ما الكتاب ولا الإيمان ولكن جعلناه نورا نهدي به من نشاء من عبادنا وإنك لتهدي إلى صراط مستقيم الآية. ابن تيمية رحمه الله said, the point that I want to bring to your attention is على ذلك كله مما بلغه رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم conveyed all of these قراءات to the people. وتلقاه أصحابه, and his companions took it from him. They took from him the إيمان, and they took from him the Quran the same way. حروفه, the wordings, they took every letter from him. ومعانيه, they took every meaning from him عليه الصلاة والسلام. وذلك مما أوحاه الله إليه. The qira'at is a revelation that was sent to Allah, sent to the Prophet from Allah عز وجل. And then the Shaykh رحمه الله brought the ayah, وكذلك أوحينا إليك روحا من أمرنا. So this shows us that the Quran, it is taken from the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, who took from Jibreel, who took from Allah عز وجل. And Al-Imam al-Shatibi mentions in his Hirz al-Amani, he says, وَمَا لِقِيَاسٍ فِي الْقِرَاءَةِ مَدْخَلٌ فَدُونَكَ مَا فِيهِ الرِّضَى مُتَكَفِّلًا. That the Qur'an doesn't have in it qiyas. It doesn't. And Abu Bakr, Muhammad ibn al-Tib, al-Baqillani, he also argues this point, that the Qur'an doesn't have the concept of الرأي والاجتهاد, independent reasoning. Somebody can just come and just insert what they want based on independent reasoning. And the scholars, they categorize the concept of qiyas in the Quran into four. They accept two and they reject two. And the two forms of qiyas, they allow it, and two by consensus they allow it, and the rest they reject it. And if you want to go further into knowing what each one is, you have to go to the Nashr by Al-Imam Ibn al-Jazari rahimahullah. He brings the statement of Makki ibn Abi Talib and his taqsimat of the qiyas, the three types that he mentioned for it. So you can go there inshallah ta'ala and understand it more. But this episode, the aim and objective was to bring to your attention that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam recited the Qur'an in the qira'at that we have. And I hope that question is answered for each and every one of you. Anything I might have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh. I'll see you guys inshallah ta'ala in the next episode.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.